We are on our way.
It's a surprise.
So, my mom, this is my mom, guys. Say hi.
Hi, everyone.
Mom, what's your name? State your name and purpose.
Lori Cross, Umpadak, Umasia.
Umpadak.
Yeah, I named my children names that I can't pronounce properly, so I'm constantly corrected.
That's why we have Adam and Noah.
So it's
my
easy
mom
for me.
Can say Adam and Noah. Yeah. So my mom, we decided to do this one just mom and I, and she was meant to prepare a playlist of nostalgia.
A little Hyundai.
My mom's way of insulting drivers on the road is to talk about their car.
That's true.
She doesn't talk about the person. She's like, I don't know him, but no. I know your car, and I will type you. Mommy can talk to the camera. Say only nice things about me while I'm gone.
Well, that's all the moms ever have to say.
Tell embarrassing stories of Asia.
Oh.
That'll be a good
there
one.
There aren't very many.
There's tons.
Okay, Topanga. My belly is in the way of this. The steering wheel is in my belly's way. That's what it is. They were all playing and they were dancing and twirling. And this is a thing with Asia. You guys tease her about popping her leg out and, you know, posing and everything. She's done that since she could stand. So that isn't something she's taught herself. That is just the way she is. The child, many birthday tributes that I've given to her over the years, is the child that has never simply walked across a room. She has twirled and leapt and jumped and sang her way across every room for her whole life. So she was twirling and dancing and singing and mistakenly stepped on Michelle. Michelle is, of course, as a hamster, is no longer with us. She was 7, maybe 8 when that happened. That was really tragic, and we don't laugh about it, but you know, it was a horrible, scarring moment for her. Sorry.
Back. So I went to a blood test to get. I went to go do my blood test for starting Roaccutane, which I've been putting off because I never have time for my skin to kind of like boil over. You know what I mean?
Oh
no, it surprised me.
Okay, well. This is what I listened to when I was pregnant with you, and it always calmed you down when you were colicky and funny and weird.
I think I know what it is.
You do?
Yeah, Bonnie Raitt.
Bonnie Raitt. The whole album, but especially this song. Like, you would not think this would calm a child down, right?
When you were pregnant?
Yeah, when I was pregnant. This album was really very popular when I was pregnant. And I like blues. I like all kinds of music, but I really like R&B. I don't know, I saw the Rolling Stones. That's where I got my first tattoo.
That's why I'm covered in tattoos and should not
say. I had one my whole life. One. It's an anomaly.
And when I first got mine, I was like, Mom! Well, the first time I got a tattoo, I had gone to Washington for like this debate thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it was the first time I was on my own, really, at 18.
Yeah, it was.
And my mom was like, whatever you do, don't find time to get a tattoo. Just go, just debate, and come back. And I was like, okay.
All right. Uh-huh.
And then I landed back from Washington.
She
and
probably
the first
had
thing,
the appointment before she landed.
I did. And the first
she researched it before she went
the
to
first
find
thing,
the best person.
The first thing my mom does when I walk back home, she's like, up to my room now. And I was like, huh? What?
Excuse
Why?
Me.
She's like, take off all your clothes. No.
I
will see
you. Strip.
You did.
I didn't make
yes,
strip.
You did. You did. Well, I mean, off. It's not nothing you've never seen before.
True.
But she checked like every inch of my skin.
Found
I was like,
it.
I got it. I'm sorry. I'm just telling you. And she was mad. I was like, but you got one at 18 too. It's not like you
True.
Can say.
Rolling Stones concert.
Yeah. Oh God. I know we're gonna. It's a good tattoo.
Yeah,
like
it is a good tattoo.
He
I
did,
like that.
They
one.
Did like it was a girl actually. She did a really good job.
It's my least favorite one's the one on your finger. I don't like that one. Yeah, never liked it, even when it was tiny.
Oh wow, people are getting what they wanted. They've always wanted a tattoo video, Mom. Here we
really?
Go. Yeah.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Well, and we just zoned out on the music. It wasn't even about the music.
Oops.
Scrubs. Asia danced to this like she thought she was a you know a
I
TLC
thought it was a
member.
Hip-hop dancer.
Yeah. Of your best
oh, you
ride.
Restarted
it.
See, my mom is like making sure you know that she knows the lyrics.
I restarted the whole thing. Sorry.
It's okay, I'm fine. I like the song.
Traffic in Kuwait, just like always.
Smart is a guy that thinks he's fine. Also known as a buster. Always talking about what he wants and just sits on his broke ass soul. No, I don't want your number, no. I don't wanna give you mine and no. I don't wanna meet you nowhere, no.
What's next?
Was that weird? Was that weird? Like, okay, because my mom, when she married my dad, right, there was no internet, so it's not like they should research.
No.
Coming here and figuring out
life. Oh, you're from Kuwait. Oh, great.
Great.
I frantically went to the library the next day to find out where the hell Kuwait was.
Encyclopedia.
Yes, true.
Yeah,
true.
There's nothing else. So, like, was that weird, like, to come back here, and then did you stay with his family in the beginning? No.
No, we never, not at that time.
My dad is a notoriously private person.
And a
Which
psychologist.
Which is why you never see my father on anything.
Yeah, we'll never see Kamal. He exists.
He does exist.
But, no, he
he's
doesn't
He's a professor.
If I take any snapshot of him doing anything for you, like we went and got the backdrop yesterday. He's like,
don't put that anywhere.
That's not going on Instagram, is it? I'm like, no, I don't post things.
My dad,
I'm not Asya.
We're sitting at home, and like I have none of my stuff on. I'm taking videos of the kids just to send in our family group and things. And he sees that I cannot be in work mode right now. And every time I pick up my phone, he's like, "What are you doing? Where are you putting that? Where's it going?" I'm like, "Dad,
it's really
God. I'm not gonna put you anywhere."
Well, and despite us always saying that, he still is very vigilant about, you know, making sure we don't.
Well, no, I mean he has his right
yeah,
privacy,
no.
But like in the I understand it from the beginning, so you don't need to like keep going. Yeah. I get it.
No, and when I said I don't post everything like Asya, you don't post everything, but I'm saying it's not my job. Mine's a private account.
Yeah.
You know.
I love you if you ain't running game. Say my name. You acting kind of shady. Ain't calling me baby. Better say my name. Day. I will call you.
It's not dancey music. It's just very zen music. Like what you would hear at a spa. That's my dad's like idea of listening to music.
And so because he's usually like reading some technical paper or some political thing as he's listening to music.
That was the thing about getting married to Ahmed and moving in with his family, which is really large.
From going from the quiet house.
Yeah, so like our idea of being together as a family is we would sit in the living room and all of us would read.
Yeah, the quiet academic home.
We would just like, we're all sitting there reading some kind of book, and if we weren't reading, then we would stop reading to watch a movie together, like all together. So it was quite quiet in the house, and it was just my brother and I. And then I moved in with Ahmed, and he comes from a family of 5 siblings, and then both the parents, and they always had animals, and like it was just a very like a lot. And I would have to, when we first moved in, I would sit with them, and it was just so loud that I just couldn't
like
concentrate.
Sensory overload.
It was sensory overload
because
there's just I'm not used to it. I'm
with
very, and I got that. I'm super strict with the boys about bedtimes, and like
but they sleep so well,
and they sleep really well. But like we're super strict. It's like 7:30. Both of them have to be in bed. 7, Noah's in bed. 7:30, Adam is in bed. We pushed it to 8 for a while. Wasn't working. Now it's back to 7:30. And so like we're super strict about it. And sometimes still, I feel like we have a hard time making people understand it.
Yeah.
All right, guys,
we gotta go.
We've got a thing, but we'll see you in a bit. Is there no valet?
Are you kidding?
Okay.
That can't be. Oh, that would be
first
awful.
World problems.
Right. Well, that happened to me at Kidzania, and I was late, and they had done away with the valet on that side.
Like completely?
Totally.
That's good to know. Okay, we'll do that.
All right, bye.
All right, bye, guys. See you in a bit.
See ya.